21-6. The Warriors visit the Brooklyn Nets. Here are some storylines. If you like scoring, you're in luck because Kevin Durant and Stephen Curry, number one and number two in points per game, respectively, this season. KD, by the way, 7 games of 30 or more points. That is tops in the league. And the teams they represent could already be on a collision course for the NBA Finals. I know it's early, but hey, never too early, right? Nets are the title favorites. Warriors have the third highest odds, with only the Lakers separating them. And they have those odds for good reason, as the Warriors are red hot, the only team with 11 wins in the league and a league-leading 115 points per game. But you can't sleep on the Nets. They began 2-3. They've gone 8-1 over the last 9. The only loss coming to a very talented Chicago team, and it was in the Windy City. So let's say hello now to ESPN NBA analyst J.J. Redick, finally joining us live here in the Noon Sports Center. So good to have you here, J.J., and I want to hone in on Stephen Curry and Kevin Durant, former teammates, of course, in Golden State, won 2 titles together, both future Hall of Famers. That said, they are playing on very different teams. So in your mind, who's in a better position to win a title this season? Is it Stephen or is it Kevin?
I think it's Steph this year for a number of reasons. First of all, they've been the best team in basketball so far. This team is eerily reminiscent of the 2015 and 2016 Warriors teams. A deep bench, tons of ball movement, an elite offense, an elite defense. Now, my answer may change on this if Kyrie Irving plays basketball this season for the Brooklyn Nets. But I would expect these two teams to be neck and neck for best record in the league, and Steph and KD to be neck and neck for MVP all season.
I mean, listen, as fans, I think a lot of people would certainly hope that, right? But you're going with the Warriors right now, with Stephen, I guess, even though survey says out in Vegas that the Nets right now have the better chances. Yeah. But we got a lot of basketball left to be played. How
about
this?
A lot of basketball.
A lot. Who do you want to have the ball in their hands in the fourth quarter?
This is so hard to choose between these two guys. I'm going to say Kevin Durant. And the reason is, his size and skill set is unlike anything we've seen in the NBA. He can get to a spot and create great offense on his own. Steph, by the way, there's a narrative that he's not a clutch player. He's made a ton of clutch shots. He's had multiple seasons in his NBA career where he has been statistically the most clutch player in the NBA. It's a very hard choice, but I got to go with KD.
And you know what? Either one, it's a win-win, right? I think you're going to take either one of those guys in your team. By the way, this is interesting as far as game-winning buzzer beaters. As the clock strikes zero, KD has 3 in his career, and Stephen Curry actually doesn't have any, which I find shocking. But again, he's had so many clutch shots, more for us to even go through right now. All right, last one. Who is more difficult to game plan against, in your opinion, JJ?
This is actually the easiest. This is the easiest question you've asked me. Kevin is actually easier to game plan because there isn't a game plan for him. He can just get to his spot and shoot over you. He can make any pass out of a double team. Steph is more challenging because there's so many different ways you can play his pick and rolls, and then because of the heightened awareness of his off-ball movement, whether that's coming out of timeouts, flare screens, as we see here with Draymond hitting him on a flare screen. They run so much stuff for Steph that you always have to be aware of where he is and aware of where the screener is.
JJ, real quick, any moments in your years trying to defend Stephen Curry that stand out to you?
You know, the last time I really guarded him was my last year in Philly, and I got caught on an island late in the fourth quarter, and he just drove past me for a layup. That was my lasting memory of Steph.
I mean, there's really nothing anybody has been able to do, not just J.J. Redick. By the way, reminder to everybody, KD won the MVP 2014. Stephen won it in 15 and 16. We truly are watching greatness, and I hope people remember that as we get set for tonight's game. Enjoy it tonight, J.J., and thank you for joining us on the show.
And those brothers have a few.
You know what? It's beautiful watching them play basketball. You know, as a fan of the game, to watch Golden State, the way they share the wealth, the way they share the basketball, I've gotten a better appreciation for Draymond Green since I retired and really watched this guy. I mean, he's a point guard. Like, he is one of the best playmakers in the game. But Steph Curry, he proved it last year. He proven again this year. He is one of the greatest to ever play this game. He is he's on that Mount Rushmore. From the standpoint of changing the face of the game. But to see young guys like Poole, to see GP, to see GP the second get his opportunity, those things right there, that's what sport is about. And Steve Kerr is doing an amazing job of allowing those guys to play free. And the excitement that they bring him, man, it's just, I mean, you know, it's just a place you want to be. It's just basketball that you want to watch.
I'm going to go someplace else with you with this next question I'm going to ask, because you guys, you, LeBron, Chris Bosh, wasn't the first big three. Really, it was KG. It was Ray Allen. It was Paul Pierce in Boston with Rondo before y'all assembled in Miami, and we get all of that. We've seen what followed with KD going to Golden State. We see now what Kyrie going
to Brooklyn. Wait a minute.
Yes, what?
Jordan, Dennis Rodman, and Scottie Pippen wasn't a big three?
No, I mean,
keep going.
Excuse me, I'm not saying that they weren't big threes. I'm talking about, yeah, Rodman was a quiet, but I'm saying Scottie Pippen and Jordan came up together. I'm not knocking it. Here's where I'm going. As you see Milwaukee win the championship, you see Brooklyn with some of their struggles for reasons we don't need to get into right now. You see the Lakers having a little bit of trouble. As you reflect on the effect that some would say y'all big three in Miami had on the game of basketball, what is it about that big three that was in Miami that you feel all of us have been missing throughout the years when we talk about the big three being assembled in Miami? Take it from there.
Well, I mean, that team was assembled. And I think why that big three stands out is because of the player empowerment of it all, right? That was decided by three guys, three players. It wasn't decided by teams. It wasn't a trade. It eventually became trades to make it all work, but it wasn't decided through, you know, organizations. And so I think that's why our big three was such an important part of the game of basketball. It's an important story in the game of basketball. And so what I loved about it is I thought we did a great job playing GM with each other and making sure we put the right chemistry of guys with CB and Bron and myself of our personalities in our game. I thought we did a great job of putting the right chemistry together. And so, you know, that's the biggest thing you look at. You know, you just look at the chemistry, and it takes a while sometimes. It's taken, it's taken the Lakers a while. I remember they're 8-7. I remember we were 9-8. And I'm not saying they're us, but I'm saying, like, it takes time sometimes to figure it all out. And I thought for us, we just really wanted to, Stephen. And, like, it was no other choice for us. Like, it wasn't no, okay, if I got to take less shots, that's what I have to do. If my points got to go down, that's what it has to do. Because ultimately, it's about one thing, and it was about that championship.
Yeah, and you got it done, the want and the will. Dwayne, I'm starting to take this personally because everyone brings up LeBron's age, and him and I are the same age, and I feel like I'm just getting started. But with that being said, how likely is this current Lakers squad to reach the finals this year?
I don't know. I don't think – none of us knows. I think one thing we do know is that they have the talent and they have the veteran, the veteran play that they need if they get in a 7-game series. We do know that. But we also know how health plays an important part in the game of basketball, especially as the older players. So we know that they have talent. We know that they have Hall of Famers. But we don't know if they're going to be able to be there at the end together. We don't know if because of injuries throughout the year, when you have an older team, you don't be able to build that chemistry, that camaraderie, that everything that you need to be able to win a game 7 on the road. So it's all going to be determined on health, and it's all going to be determined on LeBron James being on that court.
Well, let's not forget, you believe in your Utah Jazz as well, because that brother Donovan Mitchell is a star. So I'm not going to forget about him. I don't know about the rest of the dudes with him. I got to see. But I believe in that brother. Let me say this to you. Let me say this to you, D-Wade. I mean, you know, as I think about, you know, we talked about LeBron, Jordan, Mount Rushmore, whatever. I want to switch it up. I want to ask you about you. We talk about Jordan as an off guard. We talk about Kobe as an off guard. Well, damn it, you got 3 rings. You going to the Hall of Fame, first ballot without question. That's right, Gabby, I said it, so she ain't got to call me getting on me about that. Yeah, you going to the Hall of Fame, no question, first ballot. Where do you rank yourself as one of the all-time off-guards in the history of basketball?
You can't do that to me. You can't do that to me, Sine. I'm not going to answer that question. That's not for me. That is not for me to answer. Okay. I laid my body of work out. I laid my body of work out, and I let, you know, the people who get paid a lot of money to discuss it.
Okay.
All right. Like you.
All right. Let's transition. Speaking about your body of work. So fashion in the NBA, Dwayne, obviously synonymous. And Stephen A. likes to play fashion police on the show. And it's no secret.